Thank you, brother, for our exchange. I think you are sincerely committed to Muhammad. But you continue to insist Hagar was a wife of Abraham, and that therefore gives Ishmael some kind of position or privilege. I have challenged you now 4 times to answer the following question. Where did Abraham ever call Hagar his wife? You have not answered the question, and now you have desperately demanded I answer 5 questions you invent. Let's look at them and answer them one by one. Dear brother, I've also a very simple question for you. Where did Abraham say that Hagar is his illegitimate wife? Where did Abraham say that Ishmael is his illegitimate son? Where did God say that Hagar and Ishmael is illegitimate wife and son accordingly to Abraham? Why, angel of God can speak directly to Hagar rather than Sarah. Ishmael, God hears him. Why Ishmael so special compared to Isaac? Let's look at them and answer them one by one. Where did Abraham say that Hagar is his illegitimate wife? The first obvious point, brother, is that this is simply a badly formed question. Can you think of any rational reason why a man would ever introduce a woman or call a woman his illegitimate wife? Certainly a man would say, "This is my wife," making a positive declarative statement about a real situation. This testifies to the truth of the situation. He is claiming the woman referenced is his wife with all that means. Secondly, the man might say, "This woman is not my wife." This is also a positive declaration of a fact. The unambiguous meaning is that the woman is not his married wife and is not entitled to all that means. Where did Abraham say that Hagar is his illegitimate wife? "This woman is my wife." "This woman is not my wife." Logically, these 2 statements form a complete and coherent Venn diagram. There is no 3rd state called an illegitimate wife, unless for stubborn argument you wish to claim a common law wife is such a 3rd relationship. But that too is a logical failure, because it describes the basis of the marriage, common law, not the legality or legitimacy of the marriage relationship. Common law defines certain actions and behaviors that in the eyes of the law are treated as formally and as binding as an official appearing ceremony. So the word combination, the phrase, illegitimate wife, is as incoherent as the phrase square circle. But for the sake of instruction, let's consider how to approach formulating an answer to this attempted question. Since you require a statement by Abraham, the most direct answer that can be given is, what did Abraham actually say? The burden of proof is on the one making the claim, and it is on those who claim Hagar was a wife to produce proof that Hagar was Abraham's wife. This is exactly why I have hammered you with the question you cannot answer, brother. Where did Abraham ever call Hagar his wife? Abraham calls Hagar Sarah's maid, handmaiden, servant, slave, which is not how a man refers to his wife. Genesis 16:6, "Your slave is in your hands," Abram said. "Do with her whatever you think best." Then Sarah mistreated Hagar, so she, Hagar, fled from her, Sarah. no man calls his wife the slave of another woman. Part of your logical fallacy, brother, is to demand the negative be asserted. Does Abraham need to say, Eve is not my wife? Does Abraham need to say, Rebecca is not my wife? No, in fact, only Sarah is called his wife, over and over, again and again. And what does Sarah say on the matter? Did Sarah call Hagar the wife of Abraham? No. Genesis 16:5, and Sarah said to Abram, May the wrong done to me be on you. I gave my servant to your embrace. And when she saw that she had conceived, she looked on me with contempt. May the Lord judge between you and me. I gave my servant to your embrace. And when she saw that she had conceived, she looked on me with contempt. It was only for sex, Ben, only a tilth to plow. And here we have Sarah's thoughts on the matter. 16:2, and Sarah said to Abram, Behold, now the Lord has prevented me from bearing children. Go into my servant. My servant. It may be that I shall obtain children by her. And Abraham listened to the voice of Sarah. I shall obtain children by her. We have no record that Sarah said, Marry Hagar. Take Hagar as your second wife. No, brother, none of the parties involved considered Hagar a wife of Abraham. The phrase as a wife is a euphemism for sex, like a surrogate womb. Euphemism, a mild or indirect word or expression substituted for one considered to be too harsh or blunt, when referring to something unpleasant or embarrassing. Here, Abraham, rape my slave and get her pregnant. Since I own her, I own the child. Factually, that is perfectly accurate, but bound to create #Hagar2 in the social media of the day. Back to the main point. You refuse to produce an answer to the one question that shines the light on the truth. Creating a flawed question because you refuse to face the real question is not a winning jihad, brother. Where did Abraham say that Ishmael is his illegitimate son? For brevity, I will continue with the next question in the next video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.